Good morning, Life Center family. I am super excited to be here with you this morning. Today is a good day. Isn't it great that we have the entire day ahead of us? We are here first thing in the morning. There's endless potential for our day. I'm just super glad to be able to be here for our daily dose of hope. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Brent Ulrich. I'm married to Katie Ulrich. We have a son, Milo Ulrich. I've been on staff here for about 2 years, and I'm the audio director and oversee some other tech responsibilities. So I just want to start off by doing every time I do a devotional on my own, I always start off by just waiting on the Lord, asking him to come into the situation. There's just so much more power in the things I read after it if I do that first. So I'm just going to do that with you. So Holy Spirit, we just ask you to come into the room. Yeah, Lord, we just pray that you would just make yourself present in every room of every viewer that's watching right now, God. Lord, we just declare your goodness. You're a good God, Lord. You're the Alpha and the Omega. You're the King of all kings. You're the Lord of all lords, God. Nothing compares to your goodness. You're the beginning and the end, God. We just thank you for your goodness. Yeah, there's something that happens when you invite the Holy Spirit into the room. The atmosphere changes. You can feel a tangible difference. You start to view things differently. The things you read come to life. I find hope when I just take time to wait on the Lord and allow His Spirit to kind of permeate me. And Romans 15:13 says it like this: "May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." So hope is one of the things I want to talk to you about this morning, but I also feel like the Lord wants to talk about, or wants to use me to talk about waiting as well. It's not very stretching subject matter, since this is literally called the Daily Dose of Hope. So I'm right in line. And we've all been doing nothing but waiting, so these seem like obvious subject matter, but I feel like the Lord wants to do something a little extra with it this morning. We've all been waiting with this, the quarantine and the coronavirus kind of locking us down. We've been waiting for life to get back to normal. We've been waiting for our kids to go back to school. We've been waiting to see our friends again. We've been waiting to meet at church, which, hallelujah, we can do now. That's amazing. I know there's a number of friends of mine who are waiting, with our family included, waiting on a new home, waiting on a, you know, there's a lot of that. And it's very easy, if we're not careful, that this can have a very negative association. But the reality is, hope is an invitation. And I'm sorry, waiting is an invitation. Waiting is an invitation for us to partner with the Lord and reflect on His promises, which ultimately leads to hope. And I find that's fascinating. It's fascinating how the Lord works, because if we wait on the Lord like we just did and we reflect on His promises, we receive hope in our life. But conversely, the very nature of hope requires waiting. By definition, you can't have hope without waiting for it. You know, the Bible says in Romans 8, 24-25, "Hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes for what he sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience." So it's basically saying you can only wait for things that are coming up. If it's already happened, it's not hope. You don't hope at the end of the Super Bowl that your team wins. It's already happened. You can only wait for things that are to come. So why did God give us access to this thing called hope and then built into it an element of waiting? I believe waiting is important. It has the ability to purify. When we are forced to wait for a promise, things begin to stir up inside of us. It causes us to grab hold of the promises and wrestle with them. It causes us to lean into the Lord and pursue relationship with Him. It requires us to pursue hearing His voice, kind of leaning into what He has to say about it. And I believe hope is something that is relational. Hope pours out of the promises of God to ourselves. And that is a relational thing. And it requires on our end to place our trust in those promises, which then produces hope. So when we accept the promises that the Lord has for us, our hope is renewed. When our hope is renewed, it allows us to see outside of our circumstance. And I think that's so important for right now, because for many of us that are feel like we're locked down inside of our home, it's very difficult sometimes to see outside of our circumstance. It doesn't feel like the promises of God are really flourishing in our life because we're not interacting with people. We're not seeing people as often as we did. But it's still important to step back, take a hold of the promises that God put on our life, and just reflect upon those, and you'll find that hope begins to boil up inside of you. So since we all want to keep hope renewed, here are some promises. I literally have a whole book. It's called God's Promises. It's nothing but promises. There's thousands of them in here. I'm going to give you just 3 mega promises. And if these don't give you hope, I don't know what to say. But so the first one is Romans 8:28. We all know this. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good for those who are called according to his purpose. That is the most mega of all mega promises. All things work together for good. Wow. Okay, so moving on. Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I mean, if these promises aren't like just making this hope machine inside of you stir, I don't know what to say. And so I'm just going to wrap up our little morning devotional here by reading Psalms 33:20. We wait in hope for the Lord. He is our hope and our shield. In him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in his holy name. May your unfailing love be with us, Lord, even as we put our hope in you. So my prayer for you guys this morning, everybody watching, is that we take the opportunity during this season of waiting to partner with the promises that the Lord has given us to cultivate hope in your life. I hope that everybody watching has an amazing day today and that you encounter the Holy Spirit and the hope that the Lord has given you. Thank you.